All right, so Joe Goossen will give us a quick tutorial about hand wrapping. Okay, what's the first thing you do, Joe?
Oh, I'm going to put a nice little pad on there for the knuckles.
Is that toilet paper?
We won't say what it is. It looks like a nice little pad there. You know, you can use anything that's soft and malleable.
Okay.
Okay.
And you have a Mexican hand wrap?
Yes. It's not a lot of wrap. The Mexican hand wraps are a little bit shorter.
And they feel more comfortable on the skin than the other ones did.
That's right. So now we're going to make a nice little mold around the knuckles. And then I'm going to bring that right down the side, the wrap. I'm going to hit it down, lock it in. Now I'm going to go around a couple times. So now you got part of the wrist. I'm going to hit the thumb. Come back over the top. Now we're going to start threading it through the knuckles, where the most of the protection needs to be. Got one locked in. I'm going to come around again. I'm going to get the second one locked in.
Hey, you coming at 5:30 tomorrow, 6.
And one more time over the top and back through. Come through again.
Joe, how many years did it take you to perfect this?
Well, look. There's a million different ways to wrap hands. A lot of people do a great job wrapping it. I happen to learn from a couple of really good old timers. One of them was a guy named Teo Serrano. Long gone now, but he was an old time trainer. And, well, I'll tell you, the locker room, which it really counts, is the ones in the fights that really count when you wrap them.
When did you guys bring in the electric tape?
Well,
that's pretty new.
Hold on, let me finish about Teo. When he got done wrapping your hands in the locker room, it looked like, you know, it looked like a work of art. It really did. And so I used to study him, and he was the best I ever saw. He and Jimmy Montoya used to wrap hands for a lot of clubs. So, you know, I did learn from some really good guys. Now, what did you want to ask me? Oh, the electrical tape?
Yeah, because I only saw it come into action like a year ago.
No. Randy Shields used to use his back in the 70s. He liked the duct tape. They used to call it duct tape. They still do. But he used to like to use the duct tape because he said the same thing Maurice did. It feels like it makes your wrist more solid, your hand more solid. That's why you can't use it in a fight, because it is a little bit more heavy duty.
How much more is it?
There you go.
Great job.
Three.
Let's see your hands really quick. How does it feel?
Like magic. You know, they come
and when
magic
you're done working out, do they cut it and throw it out?
Nah, we don't cut it, we just unwrap them.
Okay. You can use these type of wraps.
It ain't gauze, it ain't the fight.
Yeah.
But you ain't had your hands wrapped unless Joe Goossen did it.
There you have it, Joe Goossen with the hand. Thanks, Joe, for the explanation. Stay tuned. Right here at the Goose Drip Event, I'm at EsNewsReporting.com. Bunch of back reporting.